have now come into general use and are obviously a great improvement on the ordinary modern style in use in England, which is in fact the Bodoni type.
Has moved, that was natural speech, has moved to unexpected boundaries so far. Yeah, and finally, this is the schematic of the four things we've seen. You see they are very related to each other, from X to Z to reconstruction of X. This was variational autoencoder. GAN is like a reshaped version of it. We had like the decoder of the variational autoencoder, yeah, and the encoder, but like changed, reversed, yeah. And the functionality of the encoder is different. It's classifying, not mapping to Zs again, but anyway. Normalizing flows are going from Zs to Xs, but without any auxiliary external structure. Although now we'll see a bit of a summary of the problems of each of them and the advantages. Autoregressive one is from X previous to X next with this autoregressive connection. So. We have latent space in three of them. Winona will tell us whether we like it or not. We like this. Feature disentangling, we can navigate and control better what we generate, and we have high level of abstraction of our data. We can use this for auxiliary tasks, not only for generative and controlling what we generate. We can use this in a classifier and whatever, as a pre-trained thing. And the advantage of having a disentangled space means we made that space have independent dimensions. So we are decorrelating the data, trying to find the best compressed representation. Okay? So these are very good encoders. Then we don't have direct likelihood in variational autoencoder, and well, we have approximate in variational autoencoder, but it's not the exact one, and in GAN either, of course. So we just have or an approximation or a qualitative insight, something we don't like. We like having direct likelihood values, which is given by normalizing flows and PixelCNN ones. Direct objective of good fit measurements, meaning I can have validation set, test set, and I can do the same thing as having loss functions when I can track my progress and stuff very faithfully and have a direct measurement of how well my generative model fits. Then very deep models are needed in normalizing flows-based ones. So they need much memory and compute power to get the best results, something we don't like yet. We have fast training in the PixelCNN version. It's shallower than the normalizing flows, more stable than GANs, yeah, and better approximated than variational autoencoders. But there are slow autoregressive generations in test. Yeah. And we have one-shot predictions, which we like in all the other three ones. This is the quickest to sample test data from. So as here we have autoregressive thing one by one during test, the other ones are the fastest ones by going from all Zs to all Xs and things like this, yes, in one inference. So conclusions. And I leave this to you to read because it's just clumsy text. Thanks, and any questions are welcome. Even by mail, don't worry. I know it's been cluttering. So see you and have fun. I'll meet you next week for a practical part on building something like this that I'm still thinking on which to build. If you have a proposal of saying, let's do normalizing flows rather than GANs, because normally it's GANs, a toy example with GANs, just pop me an email, something like that, or tell me now if you're more interested, for example. Because we can build a toy example with normalizing flows such that you can really understand what they do. Yeah, although I don't know if it will take much longer than GANs, but GANs I have it well fitted for 1 hour and still it's a bit of time consuming, but maybe you're much familiarized with GANs. I don't know. Are you? No? GANs is fine? Yeah? Okay. Just your call. Have fun and see you, and thank you for your attention.